And the Supreme Court is expected to hand down more rulings today after unanimously preserving access to a popular abortion drug. The court rejected the challenge to the FDA's loosened restrictions on mifepristone, saying the plaintiffs had no standing to bring the case. ABC's Terry Moran has more on that ruling and the other big decisions that could come down today.
The widely used abortion pill mifepristone will remain available across the U.S. after a surprising unanimous Supreme Court ruling. All nine justices agreed to reject an effort by anti-abortion rights doctors to roll back the FDA's moves to make the drug more accessible for millions of American women. Justice Brett Kavanaugh, writing for the court, noted that the plaintiffs have sincere legal, moral, ideological, and policy objections to abortion. But those qualms aren't enough, the court ruled, because the doctors failed to show they were personally, demonstrably injured by the FDA's actions, and so do not have standing to sue. But Kavanaugh's opinion did leave the door open to other challenges, and anti-abortion rights activists remain undaunted.
It was disappointing, but it's not the end. We'll be out here again.
But for now, the FDA's decision to allow access to mifepristone by mail without an in-person visit and up until 10 weeks of pregnancy remain in place. Mifepristone and other medications are now used in approximately 63% of all abortions in the U.S. But 14 states now have near total abortion bans, including forbidding the use of mifepristone.
And senior national correspondent Terry Moran joins me now for more on this. Terry, yesterday's Supreme Court ruling found that the plaintiffs had no standing, but the justices didn't tackle the underlying issue of whether the FDA lawfully loosened those restrictions on mifepristone. Does that mean we could see access to this drug challenged again with a new plaintiff?
You know, that's exactly right. So the way this decision came down is really the justices unanimously closed the door to these plaintiffs. But as you point out, they didn't get at the substance of the challenge. Is the FDA within its powers in providing for access to mifepristone this way? The question is, who can challenge that law? Women who take a drug are the primary challengers in an issue like this, but the women who take mifepristone want to. The doctors who prescribe it, perhaps. But really, right now it looks like it's going to be states. There are three states already, Idaho, Kansas, and Missouri, that have filed suit against the FDA. And they say that their injury, the damage the law is doing to them as states, is that it's interfering with their state laws and impacting their state budgets. That's plausible. It's a tough case to make. The states generally don't get standing. But the Supreme Court might hear that case if it gets to them in, say, a year, maybe two.
Now, the court is also set to issue new rulings today. What are you watching for there?
Well, Diane, it's crunch time at the Supreme Court. So the biggest case is coming down out of January 6th. One, obviously, for former President Trump's claim of absolute immunity from criminal prosecution for what he did. And then there's a January 6th a defendant who's been convicted on one of the charges that Trump faces as well, and he's challenging that. I don't expect the Trump case to come down until the end of the year, but this other one, the other January 6th defendant who says that one of the charges against him and one of the charges against Trump, therefore, is unconstitutional, that as applied to him, so that could be an issue. But there's also another abortion case, a case out of Idaho, which bans abortion after 6 weeks for everything but the life of the mother. There's also a federal law that guarantees emergency treatment for anyone who comes to an emergency room in the United States and who needs care. That care must be delivered according with the standard of practice in the area of the emergency. And there are some tragic cases where abortion is the standard of practice for women in very dire straits. Idaho doesn't want to provide that. Right now, they're helicoptering women out of Idaho. And so that case may get decided soon. There's a couple of other big ones as well, but those are the ones I'm looking for immediately.
All right, Terry Moran, thank you.